Alright, we are back. I'm going to snitch. Last episode, we defeated the troll. And we are sticking to it. Come and see me. I've discovered something in the locket we found in at Green Dot.
Come and see me. I've discovered something in the locket we found at Gringotts.
What are you up to now?
Where am I? These stairs, holy. Just keep finding. Oh my god, more stairs. Okay.
It is. She's right. Thank you.
Well, it's their own fault for saving it.
Revelio.
Professor, I'm glad to see you.
And I you. Thank Merlin you're in one piece. I heard about the attack. Trolls in Hogsmeade?
Sir, the trolls were wearing armor. It had that dark glow like the dragon collar.
Goblin silver! Ranrok used it to control the dragon. But how? And why send trolls to...
They were there because of me. I overheard Ranrok talking with Victor Rookwood.
Ranrok was in Hogsmeade with Rookwood.
Yes.
The trolls were Ranrok's distraction so that Rookwood could get to me. And he would have had Sirona and the patrons at the Three Broomsticks not intervened.
This is grave news indeed. If Ranrok's goblins and dark wizards are after you, they want what we found in that vault.
Speaking of the vault, do you think that Ranrok is working with any of the goblins at Gringotts?
I do not. Gringotts goblins aren't typically the friendliest of beings, but they have a great deal of integrity. No, I dare say after what happened to that poor banker, the goblins at Gringotts are no followers of Ranrok.
They're after the locket. You said you discovered something in it.
Yes, yes. I discovered an inscription. When I read it aloud, this map appeared. Clever enchantment. It's a map of Hogwarts, to be sure, but I do not know where it leads.
It leads to the library. The restricted section, to be precise, and a bit beyond. I see traces of magic there on the map.
I suspected you would see something.
Shall we go?
I appreciate your enthusiasm, and I'm eager to discover what we may find there as well, but... If our experience at Gringotts, let alone what happened to Miriam, taught me anything, it's that the path we're on is terribly dangerous. I'd like you to work with Professor Hecate a bit, before we continue.
Okay.
But sir, how dangerous could the library be? Perhaps we're only after a book.
Perhaps we are only after a book, but we should be prepared for anything. Once you've honed your defensive magic further,
well, that's actually in the back.
I'll let Professor Hecate know to expect you.
Revelio.
Schedule wasn't congested enough. The ministry has charged me with arranging the rather inconvenient arrival of a new student at Hogwarts. Fifth year, if you can believe. Professor Weasley insists that they will need an escort and a mentor to keep them acclimatized before term begins. I have assigned the task to you. Please see Professor Weasley for detail. Professor Phineas Agelius Black.
I've always said that travel broadens the mind.
Cool.
Kind soul, help me.
Are you all right?
Don't you know who I am? Zenobia Noak, the girl whom everyone at school hates for no reason.
Everyone hates you? Why?
Because Hogwarts is full of bullies and spoil sports. Leander Pruitt's one of the worst, that no-talent moon mind. I wanted to make some new friends, and so I brought my collection down to the common room. My gobstone collection, that is. I was hoping someone would want to play. Are you familiar with gobstones? Little balls, like marbles. Grand game. And if you lose, they spray you with a foul-smelling liquid.
Ooh.
Gobstones? Sounds like a fun challenge.
That's what I tried to tell everyone. People can be so cruel. Just because they're sprayed all over with smelly gobstone spit, it's their own fault for losing. Imelda is one of the worst losers. Everett and Astoria are terrible as well. And now those poor losers have taken my gobstones and hidden them in very high places all over the school.
Rather an overreaction on their part.
I'll say. Anyway, I can't work out how to get them back on my own. I don't think I know the necessary spells yet. I need someone, perhaps a selfless and talented fifth year, to help me.
Do you have any suggestions on how to get your gobstones down from their hiding spots?
I need a fifth year. Oh, what am I? A fifth year.
Gobstones that high, got up there somehow.
Haven't you any friends at school?
Not really. Natty said hello once, but not a word since.
I'll see what I can do.
I'd appreciate the help. If you do find all of my gobstones, do come and see me again. I'll be back to playing Snake Pit and Jackstone by myself in no time.
I'd better keep an eye on high places around the school for Zenobia's gobstones.
Revelio. Revelio.
No, I want to do my main quest. I don't care. No.
Revelio.
Ah, I believe we have some matters to discuss.
I'm here about the new spell you wanted to teach me, Professor.
Good. Professor Fig indicated a certain urgency to you completing your defensive magic assignments. As such, you are to learn Incendio, the fire-making spell, handy for lighting torches, burning away spider webs, and, when necessary, defending against those who would wish to do us harm.
Sounds versatile.
Quite. But before we get started, I'd like you to complete a few tasks. You may be surprised by some of them. Astonishing how much students don't think their professors know. When you're finished, come and see me. Then we shall begin working on Incendio. You know where to find me once you've finished.
Seems Crossed Wands isn't as secret as it's believed to be.
Okay. Two rounds of crossbow. This is part of Hogwarts I've never seen before. A lot of this is like.
Here I've come from the toilet bowl where she said I could swim. Did you practice a bowl? As long as we're only one time per week, I can plunge the boy's lavatory. Not for the meek.
Please, Peeves, you'll make me late.
He tried to stop me, did Rancorous Carp. Sought to trap me, confine me inside of a jar. But he failed, as did his containment charms. So I took my revenge to wreak havoc and harm. It was granted my privileges, be handsome indeed, or I'd fire up the cannon, and so she agreed. To draw up a contract with her, not with him, that if I behaved, I'd have one weekly swim! Whee!
I'll get you for this.
That's cool. Glad they added him in. Because he wasn't in the movies, but he was in the books.
Glad you could make it. Ooh. Lucan's just over there.
Revelio.
Protego!
Can I help you?
Sebastian told me to see you about a club.
If Sebastian vouches for you, that's all I need to know. I coordinate duels for Crossed Wands. A dueling club of sorts. It's invitation only, so you must have really impressed Sebastian.
I seem to have a knack for dueling.
Then you've come to the right place.
How does Crossed Wands work exactly?
You show up. I match you with other duelists, and whoever is still standing in the end wins. It's our way of determining the school's greatest duelist once and for all. And to liven things up, the winner is awarded a prize. Interested?
Sure.
Of course. Dueling's an entertaining pastime.
I agree. Besides, in Crossed Wands, you could duel with a partner if you like. Your first time I'll pair you with Sebastian. Next time, you'll need to bring a partner along, or duel alone.
I'll duel alone.
Care to step into the ring?
Sure.
Get me in the ring.
Spectacular! Let the fireworks begin!
We'll make you regret signing up.
Okay. Damn, I'm good.
Nice work. Sebastian wasn't wrong about you. There's strong competition ahead, but keep this up, and you could be the next school champion.
Brilliant. Count me in.
I shall. In fact, the second duel is ready when you are. And as a fully initiated member, you now have access to the official Crossed Wands training dummy. Very good way to master spell combinations. Come and see me, and I'll set it up. Again, congratulations on your first Crossed Wands victory. Well fought. Hope to see you back here again.
Hello, Lucan. Is the next round of Crossed Wands all set?
Why, yes it is. I've got a great match lined up. Ready for another round?
Yes. I'm ready. Let's do it.
Brilliant. Are you dueling with a partner?
Nope.
I'll be dueling solo.
Then let's get to it.
Ready to get thrashed?
Three of them?
Apologies in advance.
Venite, Protego!
That's all you've got?
Stupid one!
Protego, the one! Nothing!
Stupid one!
Oh, there goes my way.
Lumos! I gave it my all.
You did indeed. The other duelists have already taken notice of you, but after that last round, they'll really have it in for you. You'd better keep practicing if you want a chance at winning, or at least surviving the next round. I'll let you know when we're ready. Hope to see you then.
Cool.
The next round is for all the gobstones, so to speak.
Hello, Lucan. May I use the training dummy?
Of course. I'll fetch it and give you a list of combinations to practice. Ready to have a try now?
Yep.
That would be wonderful.
Be sure to cast all your spells before the dummy lands. If you need to stop practicing before you finish all of them, let me know.
Okay. Accio.
That's it.
Let me go.
Excellent form.
Let me go. Akio.
Aim for us.
I'd say that's enough practice. You looked good out there.
Thank you, Lucan.
I say better to discover one's weaknesses during practice than during a duel. You'll be a fearsome challenger now.
Assignments.
Seems I'm out of the tournament, thanks to you.
Perhaps
Perhaps I should stick to potions.
Yes, yes, usually. Oh, more.
I trust Mr. Brattleby was
able. I finished all of the tasks you gave me, Professor Hackett.
Glad to hear it. Then you should be ready to learn Incendio.
Should be, Professor.
Yes. I'm sorry to say, I visited enough careless colleagues at St. Mungo's to assure you that fire is a fickle servant. Your spellcasting has impressed me thus far, but please maintain focus. I would rather we not end today's lesson with your robes aflame. Let us begin. And remember, focus on the proper wand movement. Concentrate, and keep your wand steady.
Ooh.
Good work.
You can turn the restriction section.
Revelio.
Handy resource indeed, your field guide. I'm most pleased to be included.
Revelio.
Monkey.
Ah, there you are. Hello, sir. You'll be pleased to know that I worked on my defensive magic with Professor Hackett.
So I hear. She tells me you've taken rather well to your new wand. You must continue to work with her and your other professors to improve your skills. That said, I don't wish to postpone our visit to the library any longer. So, shall we proceed?
Yes.
Fig! I have work for you. Come.
Headmaster, I'm with a student and my schedule
Your schedule will wait indefinitely, as will your student. I would think that after all the trouble you caused me with Osric, you'd be eager to make amends. My office. 5 minutes.
That man is exasperating. Unfortunately, our trip to the restricted section will have to wait a bit longer.
But, Professor...
We have no choice. It would be unwise to provoke our illustrious headmaster further. I shall find you when I've completed whatever toils I must endure.
Oh, that's cool. I didn't realize they did that.
Sebastian mentioned sneaking into the restricted section. Perhaps he'll have an idea.
Bad news. Oh, that's clippers.
Sebastian, there you are.
There you are. You promised me an explanation for what happened in the Three Broomsticks. Not many students have Victor Rookwood's attention. What was that all about?
Seems he's working with Ranrok, and Ranrok is after something I found at Gringotts.
Ranrok? And when were you at Gringotts?
Professor Fig and I ended up there after the dragon attack. It's quite the tale. Fig had this portkey.
A portkey? To Gringotts? I'm not sure I follow.
I barely follow myself, and I was there. Anyway, we ended up in an ancient vault where we found a map. That map leads to the restricted section.
You can't be serious.
That's deadly serious.
Even though
Professor Fink has insisted that I not tell a soul about any of this. I've probably said too much.
Understood. Your secret's safe with me. Whatever it is.
Thank you, Sebastian. You mentioned being clever enough not to get caught in the restricted section.
And I am. Meet me outside the library tonight. And tell no one.
How concerned should I be about the librarian?
Madame Scribner doesn't take kindly to clandestine activities taking place amongst her precious books. So do all that you can to avoid her. She and I have had our entanglements, but I can hold my own against her. You may not be so lucky.
What will happen if we're caught in the restricted section?
Detention, no doubt. But a word of caution or two will help. For one, avoid Peeves, the poltergeist. Aside from wanton destruction of property, he loves nothing more than telling on the likes of us.
Thank you, Sebastian. I'll meet you later.
See there? That's the door we need to reach.
Prefix.
And those annoying prefects would love nothing more than to rat on us to Scribner. So don't let them see us. Understood?
I can be sneaky. Let's go.
Hold on now. There's a spell you should know. The disillusionment charm. Good for getting places you're not supposed to be. Cast it and you'll appear as little more than a trick of the light. Just as long as you keep your distance and stay quiet.
You mean I'll actually be able to turn invisible?
Something like that. It's not as foolproof as a cloak, but those are expensive. And spells are free. Give it a try.
An invisibility cloak.
If I can see you, the prefect might be able to as well.
Can you shut up about it?
Thank you.
the librarian would be gone by now.
I said usually, but it'll still be all right. Do you see her desk behind me? The key is in the drawer of that desk.
She didn't see us or hear us?
Here's what we're going to do. I'll create a distraction to draw her away. You focus on getting the key. I'll meet you outside of the restricted section.
Wait, why do we need a key? Isn't there a spell for this?
Alohomora. That's how I always used to get in. But the librarian twigged that I knew the spell and cast an anti-Alohomora charm on the lock. So now it's just this key. But don't worry. I said I'd get you in, and I always keep my word. Trust me.
You're talking very loud, my guy.
So difficult after all. Now to find that book.
Oh, that one's charmed to look more useful than it is. It's fooled me twice. Never judge a tome by its cover, I say. Ghost, don't let her see you.
Him.
Out of here with you!
My bad. You work fine. Thank you. I have to restart. Please don't let me have to restart. Please don't let me just fucking go from where I was. In the quest area.
Oh, that one's charmed to look more useful than it is. It's fooled me twice. Never judge a tome by its cover, I say.
Okay.
Ghost, don't let her see you.
Oh shit.
Should be in the clear now. No need for us to be skulking about.
So what is it you've been looking for?
I'm looking for a cure to help my twin sister, Anne, so that she can return
Rebellion.
To because Merlin knows everyone.
Why do you think we'll find a cure in the restricted section? Does the Hogwarts matron have nothing that can help Anne?
No, we've tried everyone from Nurse Blaney to St. Mungo's.
But I can research on my own. No need to concern yourself.
Bro, you are talking really fucking loud.
Let's focus on what you're after. Which is what, precisely?
I'll know it when I see it.
You're being awfully cryptic.
Revelio.
Secrets of the darkest arts.
Revelio.
Rest.
Oh shit. Cool. I know what else to
do. Who have we here?
Oh.
Sebastian Solo and his new little friend. Out exploring where they shouldn't be. Naughty, naughty. You'll get caughty.
Peeves, don't you...
Oh, blasted Peeves! I've got to stop him or at least get to the librarian with a good excuse for all of this.
How do I know you won't go to the librarian and blame this all on me?
Why would I do that? I like having friends who are in my debt. Now go. Good luck in your search.
Ooh, I don't know if I trust him now.
Now, where's that damned poltergeist got to?
I know just the spell to repair this armor. Of course, traces of ancient magic. That's it. There must be more to this room.
Revelio. Revelio.
Not surprising. Guards at the ready.
Damn! What is this? Yeah, I'm not playing my Tomb Raider.
Levioso. Accio.
Ooh.
This must be the way forward, but to where? Nearly there. Best keep my way. secrets about me.
Can I fucking take this dude? Oh my god.
It is a book after all.
A page is missing. I'm from my piece, sir. The book told me. What the hell is going on here? Who flowers? We're gonna rain. I am your calling.
You wanted to see me, Headmistress Fitzgerald, Professor Rackham.
Miss Isadora Morganach, welcome.
Professor Rookwood, Professor McCaw.
We understand that you are adjusting well to life at Hogwarts.
Rookwood?
I am glad. Especially in light of your unusual situation, starting as a fifth year.
As it happens, I was also admitted to Hogwarts as a fifth year. I've never heard of another like us.
Miss Morganach, when we spoke yesterday after class, you asked about the beautiful swirls you saw years ago when we visited your hamlet.
I recognized you all immediately. I cannot thank you enough for what you did.
We were glad to help.
And yes, I did see swirls of magic everywhere that day. My father insists it was my imagination running wild, but it was certainly real to me.
It was not your imagination.
Percival, Professor Rackham can see them too. But we've never known of another who could.
I don't understand. What are they?
The whispers or traces that appear when a particular form of ancient magic is wielded.
Ancient magic?
Few are capable of wielding it. Hogwarts itself is a stronghold of ancient magic.
So if I can see traces of ancient magic, does that mean I can wield it too?
With the proper training.
But let us not get ahead of ourselves, Miss Morganach.
Before I can train you to wield such magic, you must first master all that Hogwarts has to offer.
A magic this powerful can do great harm in the wrong hands. It must be wielded by a select few. As such, we ask that you not speak to anyone about what we have discussed here today.
He turns evil. That smile? Yeah, no, she's evil.
Oh, fuck, dude.
Sebastian.
Sneaking in the restricted section again! Yeah. I had thought we were through with this mischief. Clearly, detentions are insufficient. I'm afraid I must take this to the headmaster. But that being said, Peeves informs me that you didn't come alone tonight. If someone has coerced you, I would have you tell me. You're a bright boy.
Come on.
Don't waste this.
Let's see if I can trust you or not.
There was nobody else.
Let's go. Oh, thank you.
Oh, Sebastian. What will your uncle say?
I'd better keep an eye on high places around the school for Zenobia's gobstones.
I shouldn't be out of bed.
Revelio.
going down, should've been going up. E.
You can't imagine how inconvenient travel was before I invented blue powder.
What is it?
Incendio.
I don't know what that is. Yeah. Ooh, thank God it's daytime.
You cannot be serious. Goblins working with Rookwood makes no sense.
It is rather unorthodox, to say the least.
Revelio.
Orthodox. It's inconceivable. It's... Ah, Fig. You have a visitor. I'll see what I can find out.
Sir, I was able to search the restricted section while you were with Professor Black. It was a book we were after.
What? That's... Wait. You accessed the restricted section? But how? Thinking on it, perhaps it's best you spare me the details.
Fair enough. In fact, the book was below the restricted section, as it appeared on the map.
I want to hear everything. First, let's have a look. Oh. Oh, dear. Some of these pages seem to be missing. It appears someone has got to the book before us. Still, I will need time to study what remains. Perhaps we can still salvage something useful, though it may take some time. I wonder why it was here, below Hogwarts.
I think I know, sir. I saw two more memories where I found the book.
Another pensive. Godric's heart.
The man we saw before, Percival Rackham, was a professor here. The first memory showed him and three other professors using ancient magic to restore a hamlet from a drought.
Miriam was right. And the second memory?
They were talking to a student who started as a fifth year, like I did. She could see traces of magic too.
Why those memories? Perhaps this book will explain. Now I'll have to take it with me to London. The headmaster has insisted that I speak directly to the minister about George's death.
What will you tell them about Mr. Osric's death?
I don't know how much I dare say. George tried to convince the ministry about Ranrok, but to no avail. My instinct is to follow the path we are on for the moment and keep the details to ourselves until we know more.
I understand. I'll see what I can learn about the missing pages while you're gone.
Good. Don't neglect your studies. Your wand work is improving by the day. But you'll want to pay attention in herbology and potions. There's more to magic than spell casting.
Plenty to keep me occupied while you're gone.
You've done exceptionally well. I look forward to seeing all that you've accomplished when I return. Oh, and don't neglect your friends. You may be surprised by how much you can learn from them as well.
Revelio. Oh.
Meet me at the usual place for the final round of crossed wands. Also, the training dummy is still available.
Meet me in Lower Hogsfield as soon as possible. I would like to talk to you about Rookwood and Harlow, and it might be best to do so outside of the castle.
Oh, this is cool.
Professor Fig and Weasley have asked that I teach you...
Revelio.
Please come.
complete the assignments I have given you, and then proceed to see me in my classroom.
Okay, I just want to explore.
Trouble, are we? Been up to no good. Thought as much.
Revelio.
I'd better keep an eye on high places around the school for Zenobia's gobstones. Well, that's one of Zenobia's gobstones. I hardly see what all the fuss is about.
Revelio.
What?
Accio. Levioso.
Oh, can I Accio it? Accio. Oh, that's not Accio. There we go. This is confusing. Okay. Looks like it's math. This is confusing.
Revelio.
What is it?
I really have made a mess of things.
Incendio.
Okay, so that is pretty good.
Is everything all right?
Oh, hello. Thank you for asking. I'm Cressida, by the way, and I'm afraid everything's not all right. I may be in a spot of trouble with the library.
Nobody likes the librarian, bro.
You see, I'm fond of creating my own charms. Thought I'd perfected my light as a feather charm to use on my library books. My arms get so tired carrying them around all day. But I must have confused the Latin word for feather with bird in my incantation, because when I opened my bag just now in the library, they literally took flight.
That sounds a rather complicated way to simply avoid carrying your books.
Possibly. But where's the fun in simplicity? New charms and spells have to come from someone. Why not me? I collect the books and remove the charm myself. Except this isn't the first time one of my charms has threatened the peace of the library. Armeet told Madame Scribner they were my books flying around. So she said that if I caused her any more trouble, she'd write to my parents. Perhaps you could get them for me. There are only five. She won't be suspicious of a new student.
Bet. Write to my mom. What dare you?
Why did Armeet tell Madame Scribner that they were your books?
Oh, to be perfectly honest, I don't think he meant any harm. I think he was impressed, bragging on my behalf. Amit spends a lot of time gazing at the stars, but he knows a good charm when he sees one.
I suppose I could help, if I have the time.
Oh, I'd very much appreciate it. One of the books is my diary. I'd rather it not fall into the wrong hands.
If you could collect them and bring them to me, I can remove the charm.
Cool. Oh, yikes. Herbology class?
Yes, but what?
Herbology.
Smell. Is she growing pungous onion again?
Good morning, Professor Garlic. How wonderful it is to see you again, Lenora dear. Oh, here. You'll need these for today's class. A little treat for your auntie. Class, please welcome the newest rose in our garden. We do look forward to growing together. How thrilling it is to have everyone back together again. This year will be filled with enchantment and excitement, but the most important thing cultivated in herbology is knowledge. The prudent herbologist is no more afraid of the venomous tentacular than the bouncing bulb. Now then, today we will be acquainting ourselves with tuber known as the mandrake root. Accio. Let's see if we can't make our fibrous friends a bit more comfortable, shall we? First, let's protect our ears.
Okay, we put them in our ears. Okay, cool.
Now, everyone, grip the mandrake by the tendrils and give it a firm tug.
Damn. What's the purpose of this?
Should envelop the root like a warm, dirty blanket, putting the mandrake right at ease. Reparo! I'm very sorry about that. Yours was a bit mature, I'm afraid. All right then, off you go. Splendid work, everyone.
Wish that's how long my classes were.
For our next task, we'll be planting Dittany at our potting tables.
I wonder if hippogriffs like.
I do wonder about Professor Fig. He's hardly ever in his classroom. Most strange.
There's a bee on you, my guy.
Yes, Professor.
Firstly, well done with your mandrake. They can be rather difficult to get a grasp of.
Actually, I enjoyed it. I couldn't help but catch your enthusiasm.
How kind of you. It seems you're already taking to herbology like a mandrake to fresh soil. Now, as I mentioned, next we'll be planting Dittany. Let us find you some seeds.
I already have some, Professor. Pick them up in Hogsmeade.
You visited the Magic Neep. Wonderful! A prepared student is bound to bloom. I've arranged for you to have your own potting table here in the classroom. Wasn't easy to spare one on such late notice. Plant the seeds there now, and you can return to harvest them later. Even with soil, sunlight, and a bit of magic, they will take time to grow.
Let's see how to balance my star thistle arrangement. Niffler's fancy.
Dittany's restorative properties make it a vital ingredient in the Wiganwell potion, as you all should know from Well done! Once it can be harvested, your Dittany will be ready to use in Wiganweld potion. I'll let Professor Sharp tell you about that. Now, what say we branch out? Introduce you to a different sort of flora, the Chinese chomping cabbage.
you'll find that some plants are better suited to uses
really not?
Outside of a cauldron. The cabbages do get
I don't like cabbage that chomps at me. I don't like cabbage in general, but really not a chomp at me.
Be a dear, and let them have a good chomping.
Yes, Professor.
They're in the other greenhouse. It's just at the end of the footbridge leading out of this room. Your classmate, Mr. Pruitt, has kindly offered to accompany you. Come back and see me when you're finished. Oh, and mind your fingers. They do bite.
Heck, I kind of figured that.
Hello. Saw you on your way to Hogsmeade the other day. Nice to meet you. Nice work in Defense Against the Dark Arts, by the way.
Excuse me?
Your duel with Sebastian. And he's good.
Why can't I still hear that?
Here we are. Home of the Chinese chomping cabbage.
Oh, it's falling.
Go on. Now, see that dummy? Just toss the cabbage at it. And they'll do the rest. Look at that. Now, children, they can get their mouths on. Mum planted some in her garden last year to keep the gnomes out. Did save her the denoming, but they left her honking daffodils in tatters.
I'm sorry. What do I need to do?
Garlic said she wanted you to have a go at... Nothing to it, really. Vicious little bastards, aren't they? Mike, not saying you can't go at...
I suppose they could prove useful outside of the greenhouse. Nothing wrong with a bit of backup. Even if it is from a cabbage.
It's chaos out there. Trolls in Hogsmeade and such. You can't be above throwing a cruciferous vegetable if necessary.
Weasley.
The camp has more of them, if you're keen. Other plants too. Ones your parents wouldn't plant in the garden. You get the idea. Anyway, we probably ought to head back to class. Take your time. I'll see you back in class.
Revelio. What are you up to now?
Don't worry about it.
And with that helpful reminder as to why we should always wear our dragonhide gloves, I shall end our lesson here. Terribly sorry, Mr. Clopton.
I tended to the Chinese chomping cabbages, Professor.
Remarkable plants, aren't they? I hope they weren't too much trouble. Oh, don't see any bite marks or missing digits.
Missing fingers, okay.
As you do seem to be quite green-fingered. Oh, I'm eager to see your skill in the soil continue to blossom.
Magical plants have so much to offer. I'm eager to learn more.
I'm glad. Herbology is a bounteous subject. Tend to your garden, and it will tend to you. Huh. Well, I suppose that's everything. Do come by for a chat sometime. I so enjoy checking in with my new students.
Ooh.
Oh, those mandrakes are really relishing their new pot.
I should think, Professor Gar-
Make anything grow. We must first understand it.
And push the bus. Nope, I want to blow them up. Thank you. Alright, well, before we go with potions, that'll be the end of this video. See you on the next one.